Welcome to Suncoast View. I'm Stephanie Roberts. A big opening for Ringling College and the first peek at a new TV series set in Manatee County. We have all the video.
And I'm meteorologist John Scalzi and the proud owner of 4 Little Doggies. Well, today we'll introduce you to a Suncoast College student who is making time to raise a puppy for an incredibly unselfish and life-changing reason.
I'm Bo Beth, and I'm not excited about my next milestone birthday. But you know who's excited? Wall Street. They're celebrating a milestone year, too, and we'll learn more in Money Matters.
Hi, I'm motivational speaker Linda Larson. You know, normal parents worry. They get a lot more intense when a child has a disease with no known cause or cure. And today we're going to meet a family fighting type 1 diabetes and find out what the Suncoast can do to help. All that and more right now on Suncoast View.
Welcome to the show, and welcome to one of our favorite couples,
yes.
John Scalzi and Linda Larson.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're so cute. Although they just had a very amusing interchange about, aren't you taking me to the airport tomorrow, and honey, when are you getting a haircut?
Oh, this is the only time of the day we get to exchange schedules. This is when we're on this show.
Don't mind us and everyone else. You just go right on ahead with your marriage.
This morning, okay. I gave him the bills.
Well, since we're airing out our laundry right here, I found a little something I want to share with everybody.
Oh!
John, what on God's green earth are you doing?
I don't know what I'm wearing.
Well, you have a towel on your head.
Yes.
Literally, that looks like a beach towel.
Yes, it is a beach towel. It helps me look through my welding goggles. But the good thing is that I've changed welding goggles out now. So you need a new picture, Linda Larson.
Well, Linda Larson
likes to put pictures
of you on TV. So this was my favorite one. And she always puts a very sentimental statement along the lines of, my marriage is never boring. I come around the corner and I see my husband like this. But she was wondering why you were wearing a glow-in-the-dark vest in the daylight if you are protecting yourself from birds and squirrels.
Put up the cones. He's in the garage.
Do we have a reason for these get-ups?
Yes.
I think I was wearing that one because it was protecting me from like metal shards that was flying all over the place. And I thought, well, if I put a hole in my work shirt, then I'll have to throw it away. And I never throw away a work shirt.
No, he never does.
Oh, and by the way, work shirts are not what I'm wearing here to work.
I've actually seen photos of those, too, and they're like white and ripped and chest hair hangs out. So I didn't think we should put that on the show.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. Ever. There's a moratorium on that, right, though?
Yeah.
It's nice to know that you are a tinkerer, and I appreciate a handyman.
I like
that. We have fun.
Yeah, he's a tinkerer. We have an ice maker, under-counter ice maker, that has broken like 10 times. It's a $2,000 thing. It's very old. It's been around a long time. He will not let it go. It's dead again, but he's down there welding, and he'll make it work.
Either that or set the house on fire. One of the two, I'm not sure which.
We're not going to buy a new one, that's
very,
for sure.
Very fun. Well, just to keep it fair, I thought we should show Linda in one of her better days. Actually, I think Linda looks phenomenal.
Tell us about this picture,
because I know this is very sentimental to both of you.
Very sentimental. Oh, yeah, you didn't see the post of this. This was actually 1 month before I met you. Huh. It was when I was doing Steel Magnolias at the Golden Apple Dinner Theater. I'd always wanted to play the role of Truvy.
Oh, it's a great part.
She's from the South, and she talks like this, and she's got big hair, and she runs this little beauty shop, and everybody comes in.
Best movie and show ever.
And it was with the late, great Roberta McDonald Turoff, and that to me was a great show to get to work
with. And can I guess by the hair that this was the 80s?
No, because the whole point was Truvy is a hairdresser.
Oh, right, the South.
In the South.
In the South,
So she had big hair. It's always the 80s.
I was going to say, they've been using an embarrassing picture of me lately, and my hair looked like that, but that was the 80s when I lived up north.
I had an excuse.
This was the 90s.
All right, well, very fun. We are glad you guys are here, and we have a lot of fun planned today. We also have a familiar face in the kitchen. I want to welcome back Nicole Kudal from My Delicious Blog. Lots of spring produce I see there. What are we making today?
Today we are celebrating spring. I've got some beautiful Gulf pink shrimp, which is in season right now. I roasted those and made a nice tasty sauce with lemongrass, lime, cilantro, jalapeno, ginger, lemongrass, whatever you can muster up.
Okay.
But a lot of it you can grow locally. So.
Okay, good. We look forward to that. And John, the picture I didn't show was that you're 800 Earth boxes that you're now utilizing as well. So you and Nicole can bond on what we should be growing this time of
year. Tomatoes for everyone in about 7 weeks.
All right. Well, speaking of things that are coming up for everybody, the Van Wezel just announced its preview of its new season. And there are some really exciting things planned. And one of them is a collaboration with the West Coast Black Theater Troupe. And I love this. So as part of the preview last night, there was a little Motown show because Motown the Musical is on the docket for next year. It will be one of the biggest shows of the year. And I think it's great that they are collaborating with the oh-so-talented artists from the West Coast Black Theater Troupe. And Mary Benzel from the Van Wezel will be on our show on Thursday when we're going to learn much more. But that's something really to look forward to. Some of our favorite performers at our favorite venue next year.
Yeah, well, you were at the West Coast Black Theater Troupe fundraiser the other night, and you got to hear some of the vocalizations.
Amazing, amazing. Yeah. It was at the, it was their picnic, annual picnic fundraiser, but it was at Michael's on East, and the troupe came in and sang, and they raised
amazing.
The roof.
Always a treat.
I love their voices.
It is
always a treat. All right, we've got lots to look forward to next season. It is time for our first Hot Topic. And speaking of performances, a major soundstage and post-production facility is unveiled at Ringling College. The 40,000 square foot facility features two standalone sound stages for academic and commercial use, plus cutting edge edit bays and mixing and screening rooms. This is a collaboration between Ringling and a local private production company, and it's hoped that this will help cement Sarasota as a filmmaking hub for the region. But Beth, I know you covered this story yesterday. Tell us why everybody is so excited about this.
Well, because of the potential. One of the things that the school has said that they did not have that has kept them from being one of the best film schools is a soundstage. So now they're thinking that not only they're good now, but this will propel them to the next level. And there's already a lot of talk about people coming in, professionals coming in to film things, because one of the sound stages will be used for commercial use. Mm-hmm. And now you have the opportunity for these kids to work with real professionals on real projects that are going to be in the movie. So it's not just making a student project, but you know, this just takes them to another level, the same level they have for their digital program where they're doing animation, where they're working with a lot of people in the industry.
Right.
Same thing will now happen with their film side.
Well, and these kids get jobs, because we've had several intern employees work through the station with us, and they're off doing their craft from the Ringling training. Mm-hmm. Maybe now more of those crafts will come here, and we can keep those jobs and the kids here.
And they're already connected, you know, so maybe they'll have greater success than, say, dare I even say the word, Sanborn had a while back.
Absolutely. You know,
because they're already connected and in the industry and they've got their fingers out there.
Well, so I think that's one of the reasons they said it's going to be different from Sanborn. One of the reasons is because of the commercial aspect. And when I say, like, for instance, Antoine Fuqua, he was here yesterday. He's one of the people that are talking about using the soundstage. PBS has already signed on. They were naming, like, granted, I'm really bad with names and, you know, people in the industry, but they were just name dropping all these people that have expressed interest and are looking for places to shoot, because not only do they think we have the resources, and they're trying to incorporate, like, for instance, a theater. You can make costumes, you can make sets, you can make all that things. You can get the lighting here and get all those resources instead of having to ship them in.
Seems like a perfect match for our area.
So, yeah.
Yeah, Ethan Hawke has been mentioned. A lot of the directors from around the industry who've already had ties, they've come and done seminars and lectures.
Right?
Yeah. Absolutely. Right. Now they're talking about doing projects. So
I hope it's true.
Absolutely. Congratulations to Ringling. It's a big thing for everybody here. Well, the Suncoast is the star of a new TNT series called Claws. It's about manicurists from Manatee County. Here is the very first look at the trailer.
I got us a plan. Money laundering days are over.
Hey!
Y'all got some real idiots up in here.
Baby, it's what we do.
Biggest export after oranges.
Oh, I hope this is complimentary in some way. Claws stars.
It doesn't look complimentary.
This is Niecy Nash and tells the story of five very diverse and powerful female manicurists working at the fictional nail artisan of Manatee County Salon. There's a lot going on here, people, more than meets the eye. This series premieres Sunday, June 11th. And they were shooting in St. Armand's. Now, this is a great example of why we need something like that soundstage, because they did the bulk of this production, I think it was in New Orleans. They took it to Louisiana rather than shooting here because they just couldn't get everything together that they needed, and then they just came back and filled in some footage. So hopefully now all these forces can come together. And we can keep the production here. But this storyline concerns me a little.
It's very funny.
It's hilarious.
It's, you wonder where they're going to take this.
So wait, is the whole thing is fictional, or are we hoping it's fictional?
We don't know, to be honest. We don't know. The idea came from somewhere, right? I mean, they had to pick Manatee County somehow.
But, so that's two network shows that we've had here that are centered here, right? We had, what was it, Cougars? What was the name of the
Cougars? Cougars, absolutely.
And I can see why Cougars will be here.
That one wasn't so fictional. Just saying.
No questions about that one.
All right. Well, Americans are worried about safe drinking water. A new Gallup environmental poll shows that 63% worry more about polluted drinking water than any other environmental issue. That includes air pollution and climate change. The percentage of people with water concerns is higher than it has ever been. And experts say that the increase is likely due to the high-profile drinking water crisis in Flint, Michigan. That brought up an issue that was typically just not considered. John, I know you're the scientist of the group. What do you think about this? I mean, are we right to have water worries? Or
Well, from what I understand, if everything is working right, the water supply, the community water supply, county water supply in our area is really good. But there was an article in the New York Times a while back that said that one of the things that has not really been looked at is that line that leads from your house to the county's water supply. That across the nation, it has been, they did their own independent testing and found that a lot of the water is very high in minerals that the EPA has traditionally not tested for, but have been proven to be somewhat carcinogenic. And so there is some concern that some of those old feeder lines, especially ones that are, you know, maybe 50 years old or older, could contain high levels of some elements you don't want in your body.
Well, St. Petersburg has had a lot of issues with some of both their water supply and their wastewater treatment and the mixing of the two. You know, and then you run into things like the mosaic issues that have happened in the middle of the state more when there's been leaching, you know. I mean, it's one of those things you don't think about.
Yeah.
But then you start to hear about things that can happen, and it's just one more thing
to worry
about.
I'm one of those people that actually am afraid of this. I feel like that is going to be the next major crisis where people are right now spending thousands on cars. At some point, we're going to be spending thousands on water.
To have it.
And I think even like the bottled water issue, I think that's making it worse, because then you have a lot of companies kind of already making us feel we have to buy it.
Yeah.
And then because we're doing that, we're paying less attention to what our cities and our counties are doing. And then we're not paying attention to the infrastructure as it ages.
Well, there's a finite supply.
There is a finite supply, which worries me more than anything, is that where are we going to get the water
from? Because when the bottled water's done and your infrastructure for your water in your city has been degraded, it's going to take time to fix it.
And if your family's drinking bottled or filtered water, they're not getting fluorine in their water supply.
And they're not getting a lot of other stuff, too. So, yeah, you're right.
Something new to worry about.
Yeah, why not?
Why not?
ABC is premiering a new mid-season show Tuesday. It's called Imaginary Mary. It is a show about an adult woman played by Jenna Elfman with a fuzzy imaginary friend seen there who keeps popping up to help her out, especially when she starts getting to know her boyfriend's three grown-up kids. So it's kind of like when Mary gets all anxious and those inner anxieties fire up, her childhood imaginary friend resurfaces to help. Kind of an interesting concept here. Anybody fess up to ever having an imaginary friend?
No. No. I never did.
They're imaginary.
But I enjoyed seeing, I remember growing up, I really enjoyed watching a show that was on television back in the day called The Ghost of Mrs. Muir, which featured the ghost of a dead husband that was in the, I think it was a dead husband that was in the picture and could converse with the wife back and forth. Anyway. It was kind of one of those shows where you had an oracle that if you had a problem, you would throw it out there and they would talk to you, but nobody else could see it. And that's kind of what this is. And it's a good concept in
the
show.
I think it's funny.
I like Jenna Elfman. I think she's adorable and she's a good actress and she's really very smart. I somehow or another seeing this little puppet stuffed doll character flopping in and out.
They should have called in the Ringling Students, right?
Yes.
For that
there you go. I think it's funny. I think it kind of plays on some of our inner thoughts.
I like the concept of when you get all anxious and freak out that things from your past come surfacing out.
Do you ever have a friend, a little imaginary friend?
I did not have an imaginary friend.
As long as we don't think we have an imaginary friend.
But my same issues still surface 30 years later. So
maybe you do.
So maybe I do. All right, so that premieres tonight on Tuesday on ABC. I believe it is at 9:30. All right, we're going to check out our happy hour forecast. And when we come back, what you can do here on the Suncoast to help with type 1 diabetes.
Good afternoon. I'm Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Some big storms to the north of us cooling things down there, but we're still warm here inland areas, especially into the upper 80s to low 90s. Right now along the beaches, though, not bad. Upper 70s, Anna Maria 79. It's 83 in Venice now, and Siesta Key 81. Northport, you're at 85, but then we start to go in to Wauchula at 90, 90 in Avon Park, and 91 in Sebring, Arcadia at 89 degrees. 82 currently at the airport. We have a dew point way up there at 71. The pressure 29.94. That's holding steady. I mentioned those big storms firing off across North Florida right now. That's an old frontal boundary which continues to generate heavy showers and thunderstorm activity. That is staying to our north. That is not going to be moving down here. There's some rotation with one of those cells about 60 miles southwest of Cedar Key. That's moving off to the east right now. But for us, got some winds pretty strong out of the south. Well, much more in our forecast coming up at 5. See you then.
More than a million people in this country have type 1 diabetes. T1D has nothing to do with your diet or lifestyle, and there's nothing you can do to prevent it, and nothing you can do to get rid of it. It's a life-changing thing for children and their families. Trisha Rudd and her daughter, Emma Bella, are here to tell us how it has affected their family. Welcome, you guys.
Thank you.
So this is such a serious issue that has impacted many people. And we were talking before, and you told me Emma Bella was diagnosed at age 5. How did you know to get her tested?
Yeah, she was diagnosed right after her 5th birthday. She was a kindergartner. She went from being a typical kid running around happy to all of a sudden, we just noticed something wasn't right with her. She was started being really emotional, tired all the time. She was using the restroom frequently, and she had unquenchable thirst. She was so thirsty all the time. We noticed sudden weight loss. She only weighed 40 pounds. And by the time we got her into the doctor, she had dropped to 35 pounds. Jeez. So we took her in, not realizing that those were even signs or symptoms of type 1 diabetes, and quickly learned that her blood sugar was over 800. A normal blood sugar is 80 to 120.
Wow.
So she was rushed to the hospital, and we had to learn a whole new way to take care of her.
Well, can you explain to me the difference between type 1 and type 2?
So type 1 diabetes is when your pancreas stops making insulin. It's an autoimmune disease where your body, for unknown reasons, attacks the beta cells in your pancreas and leaves the person unable to produce insulin and insulin dependent for life, meaning you can't live without insulin. When Emma Bella was diagnosed, they said we had 24 hours before we would have lost her.
Oh my.
Type 2 diabetes, your body still makes insulin, but your body is insulin resistant. So in most cases, diet or lifestyle can reverse type 2 diabetes. Not in all cases, it can be genetic, but type 1 diabetes actually isn't genetic. We don't have a family history of it. 90% of the cases do not. It's a pre-genetic disposition mixed with environmental trigger is what they believe causes it.
Well, Emma Bella, you have, of course, been diagnosed, but you've managed to be active. You play a lot of sports, right?
Yes, I play soccer for Riverview and for FC Sarasota.
And how has the diagnosis affect you? Are you, because I know a lot of people would be afraid to be as active.
Yeah, so I don't let this disease stop me. I'm still very active, and I test my blood sugar every time I practice or before games, and I leave my insulin pump on and my constant glucose monitor I wear that manages or watches my blood sugar constantly. So I'm able to manage that and watch it. But despite all our efforts to watch it, we still suffer with some hardships, and when my blood sugar gets low or high, I have to sit out, and it's really unfortunate when, you know, I just want to get out there and play.
Yeah, so. Well, that's hard because that's, I mean, this isn't
as
just
a kid, you know, you
and it's not a low impact or low stress sport. I mean, you are running, you are contact. Mm-hmm. That is, I mean, that mom, did that worry you at all?
Oh, absolutely. she's played soccer since she was 4, you know, and once she was diagnosed, I mean, I couldn't miss a practice or a game. Yeah. I pretty much was on the sidelines until she told me it was
So she kicks you out.
No more.
Well, I had to go through the appearance.
You mentioned your monitor earlier. Can we describe it a little bit
yeah,
more?
Yes, so this is my constant glucose monitor, and this connects to my phone, and it also connects to my parents' phone. So they're able to check out my blood sugar anytime they'd like, and it alerts me at school as when my blood sugar is going low or high or falling off.
That's great for technology to have that.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And this is accompanied with a pump.
Yeah, so I'm also wearing an insulin pump, and this administrates insulin when I tell it to, and every hour as well. So every time I test my blood sugar, it connects to this, and then I get tell it how many carbohydrates I'm eating, and then it gives me insulin from there.
Wow. Mm-hmm. That's a lot for a kid, you know?
For sure, it is.
Does it require much maintenance, or once you have it on, are you just good to go?
Well, it does require a lot. A lot of people are misunderstood when I have my pump on. They're like, oh, it's easy. It's really not. I still have to test my blood sugar and count my carbs I'm eating. And despite some of that, I also have to watch if my pump goes in wrong. And I can suffer from not getting enough insulin, and I can get really sick. Even if I don't have insulin for 2 hours, I can get very sick. So I have to worry about that as well.
Now, part of this is you guys have gotten involved in advocacy and helping other mm-hmm. people. Tell me about the fundraising efforts that you guys are doing and how you're, you know, getting the word out.
So ever since I was diagnosed, we've been working for a cure. We've been raising money and trying to find a cure for this disease. And also, I've been to Washington, D.C. to advocate my cause with Children's Congress, and I was chosen to be a delegate. That's chosen every 2 years, so it was an amazing experience to go meet all the congressmen and senators.
And one of the things that's happened locally here is the walk. I know that helps raise a lot of money for research and things like that. Tell me about the walk.
So the JDRF1 walk is coming up this Saturday, April 8th at Lakewood Ranch Main Street. It's an amazing event. Thousands of people come out to support the cause. It's a fun family event. We have breakfast and lunch are served. We have so many fun family activities. There's a band that's playing, but all of it is to support JDRF, who's working hard for a mission for a cure. So.
All right, well, thank you guys both for all the work you're doing to get the word out. Again, if you guys want to get involved with the walk, that is the JDRF1 walk. It's in Lakewood Ranch on April 8th. You can get more information and register or donate by going to JDRF.org. Next, we're going to be playing a game inspired by nature. We'll be back.
Watch ABC 7's Osprey Cam on Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV, and Opera TV, and get an exclusive bird's eye view of Sarah and Soda, our own resident Osprey couple. With ABC 7's state-of-the-art high-definition Osprey Cam with night vision, you'll get an up-close and personal look at all the Osprey action live 24/7, and you might just be the first to spot an egg. Search ABC 7 on your streaming device, download the free ABC 7 channel app, and click on Osprey Cam.
My Hometown Fest is coming to Nathan Benderson Park Saturday, April 15th. Join us for culinary favorites from across the U.S. paired with your favorite craft beers. There's also great live music and activities for adults and kids. Buy your tickets today at myhometownfest.org.
Rose takes her volunteering for Tidewell Hospice very seriously. But she knows how to have fun, too. And that's what she brings when we're invited to visit patients as part of Tidewell's pet therapy program. People love to see her. She really brightens their day. She makes people smile. And in end-of-life care, a smile can be a wonderful gift. Tidewell Hospice. It's more than you think.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Minnesota Flooring.
And for a limited time, Minnesota Flooring is offering you unbelievable pricing on tile and laminate. Porcelain tile, only $1.59. Ceramic tile, 99 cents. And 16 by 16 tile, $1.19. Laminate flooring is only 99 cents. But these prices won't last. Don't miss out on these great deals. Hurry into Minnesota Flooring today.
So many times we underestimate the human spirit's drive to recover. We often see people surpass what any of us might have expected initially. The Rehabilitation Pavilion at Sarasota Memorial is the top of the line. It allows us to really bring the patient's recovery to the next level.
Tickets are going fast for My Hometown Fest, being held from noon till 5 p.m. Saturday, April 15th at Nathan Benderson Park. Enjoy foods from 40 area restaurants, 60-plus craft beers, live music, and lots of fun. Buy your tickets today at myhometownfest.org.
Welcome back. Since we have our favorite couple, John Scalzi and Linda Larson with us today, we thought we'd play a fun game in your honor. So John is kind of an outdoorsy guy, likes to be out and about, and I also know that you both consider yourself foodies. So we have combined these loves of yours into a very fun game called Tweet It or Eat It. So here's the deal. I'm going to give
I
you
love
a word.
The, name.
The word is either a species of a bird.
Okay.
Or
a species or a very fine food.
Fine food.
Okay. Oh, so we're going to jump right in. There are
dangerous.
No examples here.
Okay.
Would you
I
tweet it
animals.
Or eat it?
Yes.
Mottled duck.
Well, I think you'd have to eat
that's
that.
That's a duck. No, it's eat a. It. It's out there in nature.
Oh, marital discord. Marital discord.
Eat it. No, you would.
Can you tweet
you
me
tweet
eating it?
All
you
right.
Tweet it?
Linda says tweet it, and Linda would be correct.
Oh.
It is a frequently seen bird on the Gulf of Mexico.
Wait, that looks very tasty with an orange sauce.
Oh, yikes. Phone calls go to extension 3891.
At first, that's where I was going.
All right, tweet it or eat it.
All right.
A limpkin.
A limpkin?
A limpkin.
Tweet it.
A
limpkin.
Tweet it.
Two tweets. John, now we know you'll
eat
anything.
Eat
he wants to eat this, too. He's hungry.
Oh, one track mind.
Would be better to tweet it.
Oh.
It is frequently found in U.S. wetlands, and that includes Florida.
Again, with a Bernays, that would be delicious.
The Sierra Club is on line three.
I know.
All right. What about a Varenike?
Eat it. Tweet it.
Yeah, what she said. Tweet it.
All right, Linda is good at this game.
How are you going to eat it?
Linda would like to eat Varenike. Those are Ukrainian-filled dumplings.
Of course they are.
Okay.
Yum.
Yeah, what the dumplings are made of, we don't know. But.
That's exactly right.
Mottled duck is what this is.
All right, what about Bonaparte's gull?
What?
Bonaparte's gull.
Bonaparte's gull? Gull. You would tweet that.
Tweet it. Not a boy, but a gull.
Tweet that.
Tweet it.
All right, everyone wants to tweet it, which is good, because it is one of the smallest gulls in North America.
Did you say not a boy, but a gull, like gull is girl?
I know.
Okay.
Spent a lot of time in Alabama.
Apparently. A gull is girl now.
All right, what about a Dunlin?
A Dunlin.
Shall we have a Dunlin?
That, I know that you eat that after. It's a Lynn that has been cooked to Dunness.
A Dunlin.
I think so.
I'm not going to go eat it.
I'm going to eat it, too.
Oh, well, that's sad because it's just a little dun-colored
and they're,
bird.
They're all cute birds that you're giving us here.
They are cute birds. They don't want to be eaten. All right, what about a Dorawat?
Who?
A Dorawat.
Tweet
Dorawat.
It.
That Dorawat? Sounds like English, so I'm going to say eat it.
I'm going to say tweet it.
All right, John is correct.
Have we agreed on
you
one?
Would want to eat.
No.
This is spicy Ethiopian chicken stew.
Ethiopian?
Dorawat.
Dorawat.
Tastes like chicken.
Yes, it tastes like chicken.
All right, I don't know if this tastes like chicken. A sandwich turn.
Sandwich what?
Turn.
A sandwich turn.
That's a tweet it. Eat it. It's a sandwich.
It's a turn.
It is not a sandwich. It is a turn. It is a seabird that you can find in the Southeast U.S. and Caribbean. Apparently not Jamaica. All right. What about Wilson's plover?
Oh, that's a bird.
Oh, you eat that.
Tweet it. Don't eat plovers.
I don't know. I'm guessing all of
them. It is a coastal wader. We do not eat them. North and South America.
Well,
we saw them in wherever we went, Nova Scotia.
Oh, my God.
Yes, you could have.
I like this game.
One more.
We're going to get
I love this
out.
Game. A chawan mushy.
A chawan mushy?
No. Eat it.
Use it in a word.
If I use it in a sentence, you'll know whether we tweet it.
I say you tweet it.
I say you eat it.
Tweet it.
You eat it, and you want to. It
I didn't get one right.
Custard dish
one.
In Japan.
Oh,
yum.
Not one.
Yum.
And I'll never get into the Audubon Society.
No, you're not going to. All right, you're doing so well. We're going to keep going.
Now they're not
going
to let you in.
What about a Caracara?
You eat that.
I think you tweet it.
Linda? Would be better off tweeting.
Everyone.
It is a tropical falcon Ritty, version
burn.
Of a vulture.
How gorgeous is that vulture?
That's gorgeous.
But didn't it just say crusted?
It's crested, not crusted. And if it's a vulture, it eats garbage. crusted. Just like to have a cara on croute, please.
You guys are scaring me. Finally, a surf stramming.
A surf stramming?
Surf stramming.
Surf strami.
I'll eat it.
You'll eat that.
We're going to eat it.
Tweet it.
You should just eat it with us.
You'll eat it. It is fermented herring.
This is a traditional Swedish fish.
What are the odds
Maybe
of not even getting one?
Maybe we
shouldn't
eat it.
Oh, that
was different, yeah. If in doubt, tweet it. It's safer than eating it. Yeah. That would be my...
We're sorry.
That would be my theory. All right, this show is going to the dogs, if it hasn't already. But at least this time, it'll be superhero puppies. Stay with us.
Designers do it with style.
Tell me what's going on here. Because
you don't like my hair?
The Mark and Mandy Show. In-depth design ideas.
What is up with the tuck tape here? Let's cover it up.
Amazing beauty and fashion tips.
So Halle Berry has amazing skin.
She
Her secret is coffee grounds.
No.
Delicious recipes.
Today, I'm going to show you a special dish that is sure to please that special someone in your life.
Watch The Mark and Mandy Show right here on your favorite channel.
Are you considering joint replacement or revision surgery? Consider this. Dr. Edward Stolarski has performed thousands of successful joint replacement procedures and trained surgeons from all over the world. Using advanced technologies, Dr. Stolarski is able to perform some of the most complex surgeries.
I wish I knew about Dr. Stolarski much sooner.
After the surgery, I don't have any pain. It's like I've got a 16-year-old hip.
My name's Ed Stolarski. What I really do is I give people back their life.
Schedule a consultation today.
Don't miss Southwest Florida's largest barbecue and bluegrass event Friday, April 14th and Saturday, April 15th when the 8th annual Suncoast Barbecue and Bluegrass Bash returns to Venice. Bring the whole family and enjoy genuine competition barbecue and award-winning bluegrass entertainment. Please join us for a finger-licking and hot-picking good time April 14th and 15th at the Suncoast Barbecue and Bluegrass Bash. Free admission, parking, entertainment, and family activities. Get all the details at suncoastbarbecuebash.com.
Fun for the whole family. The 25th annual Venice Sharks Tooth Festival, benefiting special athletes of Sarasota County. Fossil vendors, arts and crafts, food, children's games, and live entertainment with headliners the Gator Creek Band on Friday night, Rockin' Rogues, Kim Betts, Glass Onion, Kettle of Fish, Paisley Craze, and the Boogeymen. Admission $4. Children 12 and under free. Parking is free. The annual Venice Sharks Tooth Festival, April 7th, 8th, and 9th at the Venice Airport Festival Grounds.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. Our promise means a new car you'll love. If not, return it for one you do. At Sarasota Ford, we promise live market pricing. We monitor national pricing on our entire inventory so you get the best deal. In fact, we guarantee it. Bring us any competitor's ad and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
A unique celebration of a distinctive cultural gem in Sarasota. La Musica, the annual International Festival of Chamber Music, with renowned musicians from four continents. April 3rd through April 12th at the Sarasota Opera House and at Saner Pavilion. Buy your tickets now.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. We are about to meet our future superheroes with some Southeastern guide dog puppies. But first, we want to talk, we want to talk about something just as precious, shrimp in the Gulf. Nicole Kudal is making wonderful spring meals with us today. Nicole, do we need to use fresh shrimp, Gulf shrimp? Are there differences in what's available?
Well, ideally this time of the year, if you can get your hands on some fresh pink Gulf shrimp or Gulf pink shrimp, it's awesome. They're big, they're plump, they're sweet, and very mild, and this is the great time of the year to pick them up. So that's what I'm using in today's dish. I'm just gonna roast them in some olive oil and salt and pepper, and they'll be a nice complement to our dip.
Okay, we'll join you in just a few minutes. John?
Yum, I'm hungry already. Well, you may not know this, but when you see those beautiful guide dogs out and about in our community, it's because Southeastern Guide Dogs counts on puppy volunteers to raise these dogs and socialize and train the dogs before they get their formal training. Guide dog training begins with guide dog puppies, and our own Wrigley is part of that program, as many of you know. There's also here on the Suncoast, the college students who are giving their time to raise these future guide dogs and become, well, what they will end up being, absolutely priceless animals to help somebody through their life. So welcome, if you would please, to USF St. Petersburg student Anthony Loeffler and his guide dog puppy, Jennings. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
So you've had this little girl for 3 months now.
Yes, I have.
What's that experience like?
It's been great. It really has. I went onto the USF homepage and looked at the different clubs, and I saw the club Puppy Raisers. It was starting out, and I was like, oh, this would be a great opportunity to help out the community while I'm in school. So I contacted Kathy Saunders, and she helped me out. I kind of went through the different things that Southeastern Guide Dogs is incorporated with their guide dogs. And I was like, well, this would be a good opportunity for me. So I went and I checked the dogs out, and it was awesome. Yeah, we're getting along here.
They want to be
friends.
We have
two teenage little doggies here wanting to be close friends with each other.
So they would like to date.
Yeah.
So how's the process been? Because I know, like, for Stephanie, she finds a lot of not just enjoyment in the connection with the dog, but feels really good because she's helping other people.
Right, absolutely. It's and that's one of the reasons why I decided to do it, because you're going to be helping other people out.
Well, there's so many questions, because I mean, a university student is a very busy guy, right?
It is,
you've got lots going on.
Yeah.
Classes in the day.
Yeah, it's hard.
How do you handle all that?
At first, yeah, look at this.
Oh my gosh, how adorable is that?
Wrigley. That's not very guide-like.
Yeah.
Wrigley's flirting.
Sit.
Come here. Let's hit it. They do have
And that's
protocol.
One of the things that you have to teach them is how to not engage in playful activity at a time when they're not supposed to.
Exactly.
Right?
I mean, that's hard. Imperative. It is hard, because it's all I want to do is play, right?
So do you take them to class?
I do, yeah.
How does she like college life?
Oh, she loves it, yeah. She loves the attention.
Think about all the attention, but she is still a puppy. Yeah. I mean, I don't know about you, but I've had a couple of scary, embarrassing moments, you know, when we might decide to relieve ourselves somewhere we shouldn't, or jump on a passerby. Have you run into anything as you're handling a puppy in a university environment?
Yes, I have, actually, a couple embarrassing moments. I guess one of the most was her throwing up in class.
That was pretty
embarrassing.
They're puppies. Yeah. I mean, obviously, happens.
Yeah, but you've got the university supporting you and bringing the dog to class, right?
Yes, they do.
Every class.
Professors are great about it. They're very welcoming about it.
Oh, that's good.
At least it didn't poo.
It could have been worse.
Well,
I think it's such a great thing that you're certainly giving the example that a college student is not, you know, just the stereotypical 20-year-old all in it for himself kind of thing, that you're working as a service, you know, project and organization, giving back to Southeastern, and then also showing people what an important thing these dogs do.
Yeah, and it really is important. And there's several students that want to do this, and I think it's like you said, it goes to show that there's not a lot of college students that are selfish, you know.
Yeah, so. That's really awesome. Well, congratulations on what you do,
and
I know she's going to be an absolutely essential asset to somebody in the community.
She is, yeah.
Some point in the not too distant future.
Yes, exactly.
Well, these two have definitely found their first teenage crush, I believe, at 6 and 7 months old.
So how would people find out more about this program at the university?
So, like I did when I first found out about the club, is go to guidedogs.org. It tells you everything about it, everything about puppy raising and everything else. So.
All right, and a great thing that you are doing for Southeastern, and we will watch these two grow into future superheroes.
Great that you guys have that club on your campus, too.
Yep, that's wonderful. Thanks to USF for that.
Girl.
Okay, coming up, it is time for Money Matters.
I know
you want to play.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5.
It's been about a month, and I can honestly say I've seen the change in me. I went from being a depressed girl who didn't want help to this happy, caring girl who loves helping other people. I just really hope that people that went through what I went through get the help that they need, because their story is important and they are loved. Thank you so much for everything.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what we're working on now for 5 o'clock, a new deal that should bring in hundreds of thousands of dollars for Sarasota County. Details on the agreement with Airbnb. Plus, a possible new park in Manatee County. Palmetto officials taking another step to turn an empty lot into a new play area. Get a check on our hot weather today with Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Bob.
Hot and windy, too. Temperatures very warm inland areas near the beaches. Not too bad. Upper 70s to low 80s right now. But you can see those temperatures really soaring in Sebring and Lake Placid and Wauchula. All in the upper 80s to low 90s there. Upper 70s to low 80s right near the coast. That's the place to be right now. 83 in Palmetto. Some big storms firing up to the north. Currently it's 82 degrees and the dew point is at 71. Humidity at 69%. You can see those big storms again staying there too, not coming here. Details at 5. See you then.
Check out mysuncoast.com/dining, your guide to the foodie lifestyle.
I'm Alan Cohn. Defending historically black colleges and universities, the White House sends mixed messages on the future of these schools. We'll explain.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
A promise was made. A promise that hit the beaches of Normandy. A vow that captured Iwo Jima. A contract that weathered Tet. A pledge that stormed the desert in Iraq. An IOU that braved IEDs in Kandahar. A promise was made to America's veterans. DAV fights to keep that promise so all veterans and their families get the benefits and support they earn. For help, visit DAV.org.
At Tidewell Hospice, we know it's never too late to say thank you to our military veterans. The Tidewell Honors Veterans Program has provided care to more than 13,000 military families since 2008. Tidewell volunteers help honor veterans through special pinning ceremonies that demonstrate our appreciation for the freedom our veterans fought to defend. If you know a veteran who can benefit from end-of-life care, call or visit Tidewell.org today. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate
or shop at Goodwill,
I'm creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah.
Now I can sing. When it comes to birthdays, we celebrate the big milestones, and apparently Wall Street does too. In today's Money Matters, our financial expert, Richard Stern, is here to test our knowledge on money milestones. All right, Richard. I don't know about this one. I don't think I'm good.
I've got a feeling you're going to do pretty well on this exam, actually.
I don't know.
There are some important milestones as we go through our investing life, and I want to go through them with you. There are four different ones that we want to take a look at. The ages of 18, 21, 59 and a half, and 70 and a half. Now, each one of those has a very, very important reason for being on that on the wall that you're seeing there. So let's take a look and let's start with age 18 and see if you can identify why age 18 might be important on Wall Street. For page 18, or the age of 18, there are two different things coming up. One is you could ring the opening bell on Wall Street.
Okay.
Oh. Or two, you can buy stocks in your own name. Anybody want to guess which might be the
I'm
right
gonna
one?
I'm going to go number two.
Ring open.
Oh, two.
I think it would have to be two. It would have to be two. I guess there'd be nothing to stop you from ringing the opening bell. But truth be told, it is number two, and it's important to understand that at the age of 18, you are considered an adult. You are able to buy and sell securities in your own name. And that's very, very important because a lot of parents don't think that happens until age 21. The reason for that is historically we've used something other than just buying stocks in our own name. So let's take a look and see what age 21 has. 21 applies to the Uniform Gifts to Minors Act or an invitation to the New York Stock Exchange Champagne Toast.
Well,
you want to take a shot at that?
I like the invitation. I'll with one, though.
Again, it could be both. The Uniform Gifts to Minors Act. Now, those of us who have had children who are now quite a bit older than 21, we use something called the Uniform Gifts to Minors Act, which means my 8-year-old isn't able to make investment decisions. So I, as the parent under the Uniform Gifts to Minors Act, can make decisions for my child. The assets belong to the child. That's very important. But I, as the trustee, make the decisions for the Uniform Gifts to Minors Act. The difference is that age 21 is the Uniform Gifts to Minors Act. So actually, I have control until age 21, even though technically my child can buy a snack.
So can you gift younger than that, though? I know for tax reasons,
surely
people might gift up to whatever it is these days.
$14,000.
$14,000 a year. Right. You can still do that even when they're under 21.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
That's
as long as they have a Social Security number, the answer is yes.
And no, I'm not going to, kids. No one's getting $14,000.
There
no,
you go. Well, now here's a very important one. Age 59 and a half. Withdraw money without penalty from an IRA. Or extra retirement account contributions?
Ooh. Extra retirement account contributions.
And the answer is one. Withdraw money without penalty from your IRA.
At 59?
That's the earliest you can do it without a penalty. Hmm. Now, there are, unfortunately, certain disability cases where there would be an exception. But basically, what the government wants you to do is to continue to hold your IRA and have it grow. But if you've reached the age of 59 and a half, you're going to have to pay taxes on the withdrawal. But paying taxes or not, you can take it without any penalty.
Oh, okay.
The penalty for taking it prematurely is huge. It's a 50% penalty and your tax is ordinary income. So the answer is...
Wait, what?
If you take it prior to age 59 and a half. Now here's the other one, all equally important, age 70 and a half, a required minimum distribution or choose your own IRA?
Required minimum distribution. Required.
Absolutely,
well,
and
that's
very
number.
Important because 70 and a half is the age at which you must begin to take money out of your IRA, whether you want to or not. Right. We have clients that have sizable IRAs and say, I don't need that money. I don't want to take it out. And I say, what part of required or minimum do you not understand?
So is that an active choice? Are they hoping you'll just forget about it and that money goes away?
Oh, no, quite the reverse. At 70 and a half, you have to make those distributions or, again, you're subject to a penalty.
Okay.
So wow.
And, again, it's taxable.
And you
income.
Get reminded. They send
oh,
you.
Oh, absolutely. Okay. Any financial advisor, any bank, anywhere
wow.
where you have
well,
an IRA.
Well, they say required. They mean required.
Absolutely do.
All right. Well, thank you, Richard. Now, you
you're
always
welcome.
Bring us great information, so we're happy you're here. And
well, thank you.
We'll be back in just a few with more.
You only have one life. Are you gambling with it? One in three adults have high blood pressure. Not knowing your numbers could cause you to lose big time. Luckily, you can turn the odds in your favor by getting your blood pressure checked today. Don't leave your health to chance. Learn more at heart.org/HPB.
The Sarasota Film Festival is March 31st through April 9th, featuring independent films from around the world, panels, parties, and conversations with stars, all happening in downtown Sarasota.
You don't want to miss it, so get your festival guide and choose the films and events you want to attend.
Buy your tickets online, by phone, or at the Hollywood 20 box office. They go fast, so get them now.
So join us to see and be seen.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
Since 2014, Addiction Hope and Helpline has answered calls for recovery and treatment 24/7, 365 days a year. If you're depressed, drinking, using drugs, or taking pills, call now and talk to someone who cares.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Most insurance covers substance abuse. You can get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call 800-622-1941. 800-622-1941.
For years, I told everyone my Craftmatic adjustable bed was the greatest until I got the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has an adjustable pillow feature that's awesome. You're gonna want one too when you see how little they cost.
If you've ever had a bad night's sleep, call and price the new Craftmatic Legacy. It has so much more than other adjustables and still costs up to 50% less. Featuring a rising adjustable pillow rest, bedside power plugs, underbed nightlights, and more. Available in all mattress types with optional heat and soothing massage for as much as half the price of Tempur-Pedic Sleep Number and other adjustables. Enjoy temporary relief of low back pain, nighttime heartburn, mild arthritis. Adjust the rising pillow feature to help align your head, neck, and shoulders. See for yourself with our 30-day in-home trial. So call and price one today for less, up to 50% less.
You get so much more and it still costs less. You gotta see how little they cost.
call 1-800-237-0214. That's 1-800-237-0214. Call 1-800-237-0214. Call now.
Welcome back. We wanted to give our weekly pup date on what Wrigley's been up to. He had to go take a cold shower because he met that nice little lab Jennings. Yeah, he's down getting his composure back. But I wanted to talk about the walkathons because this time of year, Southeastern Guide Dog does 9 different walkathons across Florida. And here's Wrigley in Bradenton. He had a great time meeting lots of other future superhero guide dogs and just lots of people who come out to support the program. And it's an important program because Southeastern Guide Dogs receives no government funding. It is all through donors and volunteers and fundraising. So here we are as part of our puppy group in Tampa last weekend, kind of out and about enjoying the weather. And it gives the dogs obviously a chance to show off some of their obedience because they have
to
maintain control. But more than anything, it's just a time for the community to understand what a great service Guide Dogs is doing. So in Sarasota, the Guide Dogs Walk is April 22nd. To register, all dogs, all people, everyone welcome. It's a great family event. You'll want to go to guidedogs.org, and it's coming up in Payne Park.
Get inspired to be a raiser.
That's right. Well, you'll see you out there. Right now, we're inspired to do some eating in the kitchen. Fresh spring flavors with Nicole Kudal. Stay with us.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you. What Florida city is best known for spaceflight?
Cape Carnival.
Cape Carnival? Close enough. What condiment includes vinegar, molasses, and anchovies?
Westchester sauce?
Close enough. And now, a word from our sponsors.
One off from the Florida Lottery. Now available for pick 2, 3, 4, and 5 games. Miss by one on any or all numbers and still win.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Haley Wilkes. Here's what we're working on for 5 o'clock. The IRS is making a drastic change, and it may impact you. The agency will now hand over some of the debt collection work to private firms that may call you about the taxes you owe. We'll take a look at what you should watch out for. Now, taking a quick look at Suncoast Traffic Watch, right now there is an accident in Manatee County. It is on US 301 at State Road 70. You may want to be careful and avoid that area if possible. Let's head over to Bob.
Another warm and breezy day today. Temperatures a little bit cooler near the coast, low 80s, upper 70s, but inland areas still hot, 90 degrees in places like Highlands County. And right now, 73 in Orlando. That's cooling down as a result of a line of showers moving through North Florida right now. Those showers staying to our north. Parrish here at 86, 85 in Northport, 85 also in Port Charlotte. More on the forecast at 5.
ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. Are you a food lover, restaurant goer, or home cook? Then check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com, your guide to the foodie lifestyle. ABC 7's own Chef Judy serves up her favorite recipes, cooking tips and trends, dining blogs, and helpful step-by-step videos. And you'll love the restaurant guide with direct links to your favorite Suncoast eateries. Whether you're cooking in or dining out, whet your appetite with tasty tips from Chef Judy at MySuncoast.com/dining.
The official salon of ABC7.
Dirty, disgusting mess?
You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
Coming up Wednesday at 4 on Suncoast View, Garden Fresh Produce is springing up all over. White Picket Produce shows us how easy it is to get our greens in at every meal, even breakfast, and how to prevent spring produce from going bad. Do your doctors communicate with each other? We're going to learn about collaborative care. Plus, million-dollar homes in Suncoast for sale. And Chef Judy brings us the best new restaurants on the Suncoast.
We are in the kitchen with Nicole from mydeliciousblog.com. And Nicole, this smells amazing. What are you making?
Well, we've got a tasty sauce to go with this delicious roasted pink shrimp. This is a great time of the year to really embrace all the local fresh flavors. So I love combining stuff like lemongrass. If you see it over here on the left, we've got cilantro, ginger, jalapeno, garlic, scallion, and lemongrass, obviously.
A lot of flavors. Yeah. I was wondering what this was. I was looking at it, and I was like, I've never seen this before.
I thought it was asparagus at first.
No, it's lemongrass. When it's in one long stalk, it looks like this.
Okay.
It comes from a grassy-looking plant like we have over here, and
so
it grows at the base.
So you use the base? Is that the part you're going to use?
What you do is you trim off the ends, and then because it's a very tough, woody outer stem, this one happens to be pre-frozen. We're tearing off the outer part because you don't want to eat that, and then it gets into the inner part is very soft and tender, and that's the part you want to eat.
Oh, yeah.
It's a little juicy.
There it is.
And it smells amazing.
It has a lemony, citrus flavor and smell. It's very floral. It's a wonderful addition to tea, to soups, to curries, anything you want to throw in there with a floral flavor.
But I do love the smell.
It just folds off. Yeah, it just peels off, and then when you get to the center soft part, that's what you can blend in the blender, which we're going to do today.
Okay.
So Linda, we're going to have you zest this lime. John, we're going to have you chop those scallions, and then we're going to pop it all in that blender. And you don't have to be fancy, John.
Look at you, John.
Throw it in there. Some good knife skills.
Holy knife skills. Show off. I know.
I know. That's why he's doing that and I'm doing this.
Nice. Nice.
That's impressive. Fancy.
He's throwing little scallions, though.
Everywhere. How you doing on that one?
A little slippery. And then, John, I've already chopped up some jalapeno, ginger, and garlic and tossed that in the little blender.
And then what's our base? Is it sour cream?
We've got a base of sour cream in there. You could even start with a little bit of coconut milk, whole fat coconut milk. That might be tasty. Add in some creme fraiche, sour cream, even Greek yogurt, whatever sounds good. Just grab a handful of the cilantro.
Yes.
Not too much. Maybe just like a bunch.
That's a lot.
Good? Does this go
that
right in? Straight in?
That's a bit much.
I guess I'll take
that.
That's
a lot. John.
That would be a little too
back
much.
Off, John.
There you go. Yeah. That's a good amount.
And right in?
Take off the stems and just toss it in there.
Take off the stems?
Yeah. Oh. Just the big stems.
All right.
Oh, there
okay.
you go.
Okay.
And then a little pinch of salt and pepper, all your zest.
So I don't know if I was doing this right, but I just started cutting it.
Yep.
Is that right?
Oh, good. Just chop it up.
It smells amazing.
One whole one?
It really does. Yeah.
And it's fun watching you guys work.
Whoops. Not yet.
We're not yet.
I'm not as good with cutting it.
Cut this lime in half and then squeeze the juice in there. And then Bobeth's got the lemongrass.
It's a very juicy lime.
Yeah, this is a great time of the year for some of these flavors because folks can grow them in their own gardens. As a matter of fact, I'm growing some lemongrass, cilantro, jalapeno, and ginger.
Wow. How's lemongrass grow? Is it good?
It grows very easily.
Yeah. Wait a minute, you're growing ginger?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's very easy to do. There's a lot of edible ginger varieties, and it's pretty effortless to grow.
All right, we're getting down to our final minute.
Turn it on.
All right, so give it a blend.
Off.
Turn it on, and then hit food processor. All right, while we mix that up, we want to say thank you to John and Linda for coming in to cook with us. I can tell John is quite handy in the kitchen, doing lots of cooking at home.
And how long did you roast the shrimp?
Maybe just about 5 minutes. You don't want to overcook them, so I just sprinkled some salt and pepper and olive oil.
All right, my delicious blog, a great roasted shrimp recipe with a spring dip. It smells absolutely fresh and fabulous. So, Nicole, thank you for sharing.
Thanks for
John
having me.
John and Linda, thanks for joining us. And enjoy the spring weather.
Thank
Take
you.
Some time and enjoy the Suncoast view.
Yeah.
That's good.
Share. Too many.